So today we're not going to be talking about trombones. Today I'm going to be talking about this instrument here. Now, astute people will know that this is a sousaphone. The more astute will know that it isn't a normal sousaphone. Normal sousaphones are pitched in the key of B flat, and whilst this is also pitched in the key of B flat, this is an octave higher than a normal sousaphone. It's half the size. So taking it off for a moment, we can see that it's got the traditional forward-facing bell that's incredibly large. It separates around here. There's this a little collar here, and there are three rather obvious screws which hold the bell in place. There's this brace here which serves no musical purpose, it's just to strengthen the instrument. And interestingly enough, there is a tube that runs from here all the way around through to here, and this isn't actually musically necessary either. This is just to give the instrument its shape. You'll notice at this junction here that this tube here is the one where air goes through. This is just sort of soldered on and tacked on in place, and likewise at the other junction at the bell here, it's just tacked on there as well. No air goes through this tube, it is a sealed unit, and it's only there to give the instrument its shape. This flat piece of metal here is just for comfort. It's quite inconvenient when you play it because it makes the instrument not really fit my particular body size, but it's just a brace here. The instrument has three valves like most sousaphones. Sousaphones, although they're pitched in the same key as most sort of marching tubas are, they only have three valves instead of the four or more valves that B-flat tubas will have, and that is largely to cut down on weight. B-flat tuba is a heavy instrument, especially the ones that are made out of old, you know, the old style metal, and so they cut down on weight by only having three valves. This is similar, it's only got three valves as well. They've got a sort of hexagonal design on the valve caps here for whatever reason that was necessary. They've got a thumb ring here which is so small I can't even put my thumb through it. I can fit my index finger just over halfway and so forth, but my thumb won't fit through this. It's completely pointless as far as the thumb ring is concerned. The valves are very heavy. The springs are very solid. I've put some valve oil on this, I've cleaned them up a little bit. But this instrument is made by an Indian company, SAI Musical. I don't know if you pronounce that as three letters or as SAI or something else, but this instrument is manufactured from them. I went on their website, it's probably one of the poorest websites I've seen, but they seem to sell this instrument brand new for about $550 to $600. Don't buy one. So I bought this instrument off an auction site, and due to some logistical reasons I wasn't able to demonstrate it, to try it out beforehand. The auction simply said has some tuning issues in the higher register. Well, that is about the understatement of the century. This instrument is unusable because of those tuning issues. I can fit quite comfortably in this instrument, even though it is a lot smaller than a full-size sousaphone. But there is no movement at all on this mouthpiece receiver. It is stuck in place, so it is quite awkward to hold. And the mouthpiece is at a very inconvenient angle. You sort of have to play it like this in order to get your mouth fitting over it properly. But that is the least of your problems. Because if we start playing some notes, we can hear that we've got some air leaks. That is not the sound, or at least the sound that is coming out of this bell, from my point of view, is not the sort of sound that I'd want to hear. It sounds like there are air leaks throughout it. I've checked the seal around the bell joint here. That is as good as you'd expect. I've made sure that the mouthpiece doesn't rattle around in the mouthpiece receiver. So I just presume there are some air leaks elsewhere. First thing I'd check is the spit valve to see whether that was creating a seal when it was closed. But there isn't a spit valve on this. I mean, that's a bit silly. But anyway, those tuning issues that I was telling you about. Well, let me play a scale for you. That, so far, not too bad. Not great, but not too bad. I mean, that's just awful. What is that? So I'll demonstrate what a concert F major scale sounds like on a baritone, and then I'll play the exact same thing on here just to hear the extent of these tuning problems. And this is a concert E flat major scale. I mean, I think this instrument is pretty much unusable. I don't know whether there are issues with air leaks throughout the valve section, or I don't know where the problem exists, but this is not an instrument that I would ever recommend anyone having. Over the last couple of days, I've put up some videos of old brass band concerts and pieces of music that I've played in previous years. Hope you guys have enjoyed that. I don't know whether that is something you want to see more of or less of. So if you want to, feel free to let me know, then I can upload content accordingly. Thanks very much for watching.